Hello everyone and welcome back. In this video, we're talking about viewport navigation. So what is viewport navigation? Well, it is the act of navigating our viewport here. So there are a couple different ways that we can go about doing this. We'll explain each of these methods, and hopefully you're following along inside the editor so that you can experiment as we describe them. And then you can use whatever method you're most comfortable with. So let's get started. The first method that we'll talk about is referred to as mouse navigation. So inside our viewport here, I'm going to hold the left mouse button down and move the mouse forward to make me go forward, and backwards to make me go back, and to the left to make me turn left, and to the right to make me turn right. So forwards, backwards, left, and right. And left again, so that we're looking at our tables and table and chairs here. Okay, so that is movement. As far as looking around with the mouse style of navigation, if you go ahead and click and hold the right mouse button, this acts as essentially a free cam, allowing you to look in any direction. You will remain stationary while you do this, but holding the right mouse button and going forward makes you look up, and back makes you look down, left makes you look left, and right makes you look right. So that's just holding the right mouse button down and moving your mouse around. Now you can hold the middle mouse button and use that to track the camera. So if I move forward while holding the middle mouse button down, you see I go up, and backwards makes me go down, left makes me go left, and right makes me go right. That's just holding the middle mouse button down and dragging. Oops. Now, if you do not have a middle mouse button, you can hold down the left and right mouse buttons together. That will give you the same effect. So tracking up, tracking down, tracking left, and tracking right. Okay, you can change the speed at which you are moving inside your viewport. If you look in the upper right-hand corner, there's a camera speed option. If you go ahead and click that, right now we're defaulted to 4, but we can bump this down to 1, for example. And inside our viewport here, if we left mouse button and drag, you can see we're moving a lot slower now, moving slowly forward towards our statue, and we can move away from it slowly. But if we have a large level, for example, we can bump this all the way up to 8, and now you can see we're flying really fast across our level. So this could be useful, like I said, if you have a huge level that you just want to fly around really quickly. So that's going to do it for that method of navigation. Before I forget, let me bump this back to 4, to the default setting here. The second method of navigation is referred to as the WASD method, or the WASD method. And if you're familiar with a first-person shooter, you should feel right at home with this method of navigation. All I'm going to do inside the viewport here is hold the right mouse button and press the W to make me go forward, S to make me go back, A to make me go left, and D to make me go right. If you recall in the previous method, we said that the holding down the right mouse button allows you to look around. So using that in conjunction with WASD, you can see we can fly around in our level just by pitching the camera. I'm just holding down W and aiming where I want to go by moving my mouse and holding the right mouse button. To use the WASD method, you don't have to use the right mouse button. You can hold the left mouse button or the middle mouse button and still use WASD to fly around. However, you're not going to have that camera control, so you can't pitch the camera. So typically, you're going to want to hold the right mouse button so that you can look around as you're flying. But it's up to you how you would like to use that method. Now there's a couple other controls that come into play when using the WASD method. Again, if I hold the right mouse button here and I press E, that's going to make me go up, and Q is going to make me go down. So E, elevator going up, and Q, quickly going back down. If I press the C key, I will zoom in or change the field of view to zoom in on something if I wanted to get a nice close-up shot of this chair. Or I could press Z to zoom way out, as you can see here. So C to zoom in, and Z to zoom out, excuse me. The good thing about this is once I release the mouse button, the camera will pop back to its default location. So it's just good if, like, if you want to look at something really quickly, like our statue here, I just want to zoom in on it really quickly and look at the bottom of it for some reason. I can do that, and then releasing to pop the camera back. There's one other thing you can do that is only specific to the WASD method. We talked about changing the camera speed here. While holding the right mouse button down and pressing the S key to zoom or move away from our tables and chairs here, I can roll the mouse wheel up to make me go faster, I'm going to press W to go back towards our tables and chair here. And if I move the mouse wheel down, you can see we're moving slower. So rolling it up faster, down slower. Now this isn't necessarily changing our camera speed up here. If you notice, you take a look in the upper right hand corner here. As we roll the mouse wheel, it's not necessarily changing the camera speed. It's more of an offset to our current camera speed. So we're moving at a faster 4 and a slower 4, not necessarily changing the camera speed itself. Just thought I would mention that. The final method of navigation, navigating your viewport, is through the Maya style of navigation. Those of you familiar with Maya may feel more at home with this style of navigation. To use this method, what we're going to do is hold the Alt key and the left mouse button, and that allows you to tumble the camera. So we can kind of tumble around our tables and chairs here. It's not necessarily pivoting how I would like. It's currently pivoting right here. But if we wanted to look at a specific object, what we could do is click on it and then press the F key to frame up on it, and then hold Alt and use the left mouse button. Now we're tumbling around just a specific object, so we can kind of see it from all angles and get a closer view at it from every angle. We can also hold down Alt and use the right mouse button. This will allow us to dolly the camera toward or away from an object. So holding down Alt and the right mouse button and pushing up makes me zoom away. Pulling back makes me zoom in. You can also do this by going left and right. So left makes me pull away, right makes me pull in towards the object. And then finally, holding Alt and using the middle mouse button allows you to track the camera up or down or left or right. So holding Alt and middle mouse button forward makes me go up, back makes me go down, left makes me go right. Or left makes me go left, and right makes me go right. That would be something if left made me go right, wouldn't it? Okay, that is going to do it. Let's summarize again really quickly. The mouse navigation, holding down the left mouse button and dragging forward, backwards, turning left, turning right. Holding down the right mouse button to kind of look around. The middle mouse button is used for tracking the camera up, down, left, and right. Holding down a mouse button, either the left, right, or middle mouse button, preferably the right mouse button, and the W key to fly around. Forward is W, backward is S, A is left, and D is right. And then E makes us go up, G makes us go down, C makes us zoom in, and Z makes us zoom out. That's all done by holding down a mouse button and pressing those keys. As soon as I release the right mouse button, camera pops back to its default location. The Maya style controls, so I'm gonna select an object here and just frame up on it. So we're looking at this statue here. I'm going to hold down Alt and use the left mouse button. Hold the left mouse button down and drag the mouse around to kind of tumble around this object here. I'm going to hold down the right mouse button now to dolly the camera away by moving it left. Dolly it in towards moving it right. Dolly it away by going forward on the mouse, and dolly it in by pulling back. So that's going to sum it up. Hopefully you guys were following along inside the editor. Go ahead and experiment and see which one you're most comfortable with. Thank you guys for tuning in, and we hope to see you in the next video.